reason my time lapse didn't like going that long without a stop, so we're just gonna do it the old fashioned way. I'm gonna move him over to the table, start drying him. Cross your fingers that the electricity works. That's the only thing I'm worried about. So here we go. So I know I didn't use the proper form for lifting a heavy dog, but hey, at least I can still do it, right? Oh, get better with time. So what I like to do is I like to dry him off with a towel first. It gets the bulk of the water off when drying, and they like it when you can kind of hurry up and get the water off of their face. I've noticed with dogs that it's not necessarily the body that bothers them getting wet. It's more their face and nose and all the sensitive area that they really mind getting wet. So I try to dry that off first. With new dogs, since this is family, this is a family dog. With dogs that I'm not familiar with, I try to like go under the chin just to kind of keep it from like trapping them. I don't want to trap the dog. So I go under the chin and just kind of wipe off one side at a time so they can still see. So they're not like blind, like, hey, what's going on? And so yeah, sometimes I use more than two, but generally like if I'm grooming somewhere, I'll try and just use two to get the bulk of the water off. He's a big dog, so we're going to use three just so that we can help the blower as much as we can. Because electricity is kind of a question mark right now today, helping the blower as much as we can is going to be a big help. So Odysseus, he's a 3-year-old Great Pyrenees, and he's really a good dog. He's kind of goofy at times, like most dogs with his disposition are. He's a middle of the road temperament kind of dog, not really hyper, not too low, just kind of just right. Most likely yeast in his ears, and so his ears sometimes stink. So I'll try my best to clean them. I don't have any ear cleaner at this point, just because I only do grooming for fun right now. But yeah, his ears are pretty dirty. way down to his ear canal, but try to be gentle as possible while giving a good scrub. And then don't do like I just did and wipe all the ear gunk while you're trying to dry. Okay, so next I'm gonna put this harness on him. For dogs that I don't know, this helps me to, like, when I'm blowing, sometimes the blower scares them and they tend to act unpredictably, and so the harness helps me kind of keep them on the table and gain control. And then I'll just hold the blue, like the hip loop, to keep them from kind of sliding that way off the table, and it helps a lot. I usually don't tighten it, it's like it only goes so far, so he's not constricted as far as breathing. And then I always have their loop leash. I like to tie it on the side, because if I tie it up here, he'll kind of just go around and around and end up tangling this into that harness, and you don't really want that. He's already shedding a lot. I've got some of it in my mouth from washing him, so. Let's see, what else, Odysseus? What else? So I think we're ready to blow, so here we go. Just to test the water, so to speak, and like, is it okay if I blow you? Okay, if it's okay, then we're gonna go ahead. But usually, I'll start at the head, and then I'll kind of work my way down this way. And so, start at the head and kind of do all the way down to the feet, then start back up to the top and go all the way down, and kind of keep. Kind of from the top down as we go backwards, and then I'll do a side at a time, just to kind of keep me centered and focused, because if I just go haphazard and I'm blowing on either side, I could blow the water off that way and make that side wet again, and so I'm doing twice the work. With a blower, it's important to remember that that's what it is. It's a blower. It's to blow the water off. And so some people will be frustrated by blowing and blowing, and they're like, but he's not getting dry, the animal's not getting dry. And so you want to keep that in mind, like, you're blowing the water. So I start here, I'm blowing this water off, and then when that's dry, I'm blowing that off, I'm blowing that water off. And so keeping an eye on, like, the direction that your water's going, the direction that your blower's pointed, that's going to affect how long it takes to dry them. And so, one side at a time, just to stay focused.